I'm going to give 10 seconds for the live audience to join us. All right, welcome to Mixing Night. I'm your host, Ken Lewis, and I have been Forrest Gumping my way through the music industry for almost 30 years now. So don't challenge me to ping pong or sprint mixing. Forrest Gump always has a butterfly effect on the world around him, and that's often my role in the music industry. I get a lot of, like, designated hitter calls to do anything from very traditional roles like mixing and production to very unique, singular, sometimes small roles on big songs like Uptown Funk, We Are Young, All of the Lights, Girl on Fire, hence weirdest resume in the music industry. And you can check it out at kenlewis.com. I've also noticed through teaching that the butterfly effect that I've had on people who work in this industry and who just make music in general, man, it's just awesome. And let me tell you that the recognition that you've been an influence on somebody, man, that just beats a gold record any day of the week, I promise you. So tonight's show is a banger. Here is the rundown. I'm kicking off the night with a sprint mix of Down On Me by Jeremih and 50 Cent. Ooh, I should get the blood pumping. We lost DMX this week. Rest in peace, DMX. Later on, I'm going to tell you one of my two DMX stories, both of which are in the top tier of my all-time best studio stories. The second one kind of has to be acted out, and I don't think this is the right one, but I'm going to tell you, and it involves the FBI, so it's an interesting government night. You'll see for other reasons, too. So I got some great pre-submitted questions for me to answer tonight, and you can ask your questions live on the chat roll. I have someone on the chat roll grabbing the best ones and feeding them to me on a screen off to my right, so I do see them, even though I'm not monitoring the chat roll in real time. Although we go back and watch the chat roll, and we just love what you guys are bantering back and forth, so good to have you guys with us. Ear training tonight is rapid fire frequencies. Only real world challenges around here, guys, you know. But seriously, tell a friend about ear training, then challenge them to an ear training competition and push each other to improve. And hey, bring people into the room tonight. If you're watching, you know, reach out to a friend right now and let them know that we're live, and they, you know, they might thank you. I'll certainly thank you. But I've also been hearing about people having get-togethers and having ear training challenges live. So if that's happening in, like, dorm rooms or studios or anything like that, I think that's really amazing. And also keep in mind that you can go back to previous episodes and find the ear training, download the worksheet, and take those ear training challenges as well. I don't know why my mouse is not... Uh-oh. Ooh, this could be a short night. Beat challenge top entries with shout outs. So many cool creative lanes that we went down tonight. Two of the beat challenge entries, I requested stems from the creatives, and basically I took the full stems of their beat challenge entry, and I'm showing how to improve the mix. Probably the first 20 minutes, I'm going to pull up one of those sessions by, I think, Jeremih Heatlie. Hi, Mazikeen. So we are joined by Mazikeen Lewis tonight on the Mazzy Cam. She is looking for pets and treats tonight. So we had salmon for dinner, and Mazikeen gets the salmon skins. She is so spoiled. She's got us wrapped around her finger. I also, several of the beat challenge entries, I did a little bit of mastering on. So I'll show you some very subtle to very drastic mix bus finishing techniques tonight using that brand new Plugin Alliance BX Limiter True Peak. Basically, what I did with the beat challenge is I, like, DJ'd them all in a row, 8 bars of each one all in a row, but then I used the True Peak limiter to basically be a mastering and even out each one, so they're all at a consistent level. So I'll show you all that. Marcus Manderson, Mixing Night Man of Mystery, brings you another great segment on free gear. This week he spotlights Cymatics Diablo drum enhancer. Doesn't he, Mazzy? You gotta lay down. Hey, lay down. Good girl. All right. Mazzy is a little spoiled tonight. So, what else is going on? Career is going well. Our artist Harler released their song Heart Games on Friday. Please support. I'll play you a little bit. I'll play you some of that song in a little bit. We're also wrapping up production on a killer new Skrizzly Adams song that will be out soon, so keep an eye out for that. And I do have some preliminary news to share. So, I was visited last week by a recently former second in command at the CIA. the deputy director of the Central Intelligence Agency. Yep. And he and I are working on a top secret project that obviously I can't talk about yet, but I just want to say that I lead a very strange and charmed life. And that's all I'm going to say about that right now. But speaking of charmed lives, I'm creating a plugin, and it's totally awesome. I am absolutely in love with this thing. We've been working on a prototype of it. I might show it next show. I'm hoping to show it next show. But I think it's going to be available in about 2 months, and maybe we'll be betaing it in about 4 to 5 weeks. But you guys are going to love this thing. And basically what happened was, we needed to figure out how to keep Mixing Night going for free after the pandemic and after I'm vaccinated and after I can kind of get back to traveling and working and being around people again. And we are strategizing all of these different, you know, do we charge for the show? No, I don't want to do that. Do we, you know? So we basically said, well, you know, what about a plug-in? And so we kicked around to the idea and we just fell in love with it. And then we designed it. Lori named it and Lori did the mock-up design on it. You guys are going to love this. I can't wait to show you. Okay, moving on. What else is going on? Sprint mixing. So, okay. Imagine someone created a real-time video game for mixing that was player one with escalating randomized challenges. Well, that's what I did. That's called sprint mixing. And I'm about to do Down on Me Jedi Level 6 sprint mix. So I did the full mix of Jeremih and 50 Cent Down on Me. It was like 109 tracks. And that song went to number one on the charts and stayed on the singles charts for 7 months. Was incredible. This is, I stemmed out mixed stems, 30 mixed stems, and I have 10 minutes on the clock, all faders down, and I need to make it sound like a song in 10 minutes. That's what sprint mixing is. And the thing about sprint mixing is, I'm not trying to teach you how to mix a song lightning fast. That's not really the point. Although, if you're in a high-pressure situation, you are going to be damn glad that you did a bunch of sprint mixing, because it really hones your instincts and your gut and your ability to balance two sounds against each other very quickly and move on to something else. That's really the power of sprint mixing. It's not mix fast. It definitely helps your mixing better than anything else, but... yeah. So anyway, I'm going to do Down on Me in a few minutes. Stay tuned for that. Actually, I think I'm just going to get to it. But let me show you real quick. For those who didn't know, I have a school. Audioschoolonline.com is my school. And I did a three-part free tutorial series on how I mixed the full original 109-track session of Down on Me. It's an hour and a half, three-part series that I put out many years ago, but it's still, I mean, if you want a serious mix breakdown of a hit, there it is. And while you're at it, you can go to the tutorial section and pick up some sprint mixes and try your luck. So there are different levels. There are 1 through 6. Level 1 is like, I've never mixed anything in my life. I don't know what to do. Level 1 is perfect for you. And then just like a video game, it levels you up all the way until level 6. And if you can do level 6 at my level, that's Jedi shit. So good luck with it. And we're giving that away later on tonight, the UVI Falcon 2. The winner of the beat challenge is going to win the UVI Falcon 2. Beast mode. I love that thing. I use the UVI Falcon 2 all the time. And it's a workstation. It's kind of like, what would it be similar to? Contact, or, you know, the NI or the Arturia or any of those like full collections. The hey, spoiled girl, lay down. There you go. Mazakeen Lewis is really demanding tonight. Oh, good girl. Okay, she's a sweetheart. Okay, so I'm going to put 10 minutes on the clock and get to sprint mixing. Let's see. Even though I'm vaccinated, I'm still masking up. State law in New Jersey, anytime you're out working, so I'm supporting. And let's see. Here we go. 10 minutes on... Oh, not 1 hour, Ken. Jesus. 10 minutes on the clock. And where are my heavy metal lights? Welcome to Mixing Night. Thanks for joining me. This is Ken Lewis and Mixing Night. You found it. Man, we're going to have fun tonight. It is just action-packed. 10 minutes, and it's go time.
Thank you. licky, licky, licky till I run and keep you gunning till you empty.
Bang, 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 bang.
Oh, you look so sweet. What you working, Alice? Look at your physique. Girl, you are a beauty. Well, I am a beast. They must have been tripping to have left me off a leash.
I'm all on it.
We get the party going, liquor flowing. This is me to push up on it, for she know. We get the party me to push up on it, for she know where I'm all on it. We get the party going, liquor flowing. This is fire, 50 in Jeremiah.
Tapping, tripping to have left me off a leash.
When you grind with that.
Tapping, tripping to have left me off a leash. Me off a leash.
I like the way you grind with that.
Been tripping to have left me off a leash.
I like the way you grind with that booty. Oh.
Been tripping to have left me off a leash.
I like the way you grind with that booty.
Oh. You don't know me.
Perfect team. Roll the hips and drop it down like it's nothing. She hit just like an hourglass. See how fast an hour passed. Time flies when on that ass. Shit on blur. Work it like a pro. Sit and watch it go. Thing out on the floor, she bouncing fast, she shaking slow, so sexual, incredible, she beautiful, she edible, I gotta, I won't let her go, I ain't seen nothing better, yo,
look how she twerk it, the way she work it, make me wanna hit it, heaven when I'm in it, if I do not fit, I'm gonna make it, girl, you can take it, don't stop, get it,
okay.
Put it down up on me, say you independent, get it from your mama, tell me if you're with it, do you really wanna? Baby, when you see me, you know I'll be on it. Can you keep it up and put it down up on me, down with that booty? Can you keep it up, up and put it down up on me? Say you're independent, get it from your mama. Tell me if you're with it, do you really wanna? Baby, when you see me, you know I'll be on it. Can you keep it up and put it down up on me, down with that booty? Oh, me, oh, Charlie, you.
She want it, I can tell she want it. Want me to push up on it, for she. She want it, I can tell she want it. Want me to push up on it, for she know where I'm all on it. We get the party going, liquor flowing, this is fire. Vicky and Jeremiah, number one, there's nothing higher.
Won't you
get it, get it. Get
I
it,
see you, baby.
Work it, break it,
won't
break
you
it
just
down,
put it down.
Won't you down.
Okay, she headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Something like my wrist beats, everybody got to watching it.
gon' put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not on it. Miss Vicky, heard you got that sticky. Let's go and take 9 shots. Girl, you got. I'm gon' put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not on it. Miss Vicky, heard you got that sticky. Girl, you got that secret treasure. I'm gon' put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not on it. Miss Vicky, heard you got that sticky. Let's go and take 9 shots, we'll just call it 50. And I gonna lick it, lick it, lick it till I icky. Had that ripper running, keep you gunning till you empty.
Bang, 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 bang.
Oh, you look so sweet. What you working about, Alice? Look at your physique. Girl, you are a beauty, but well, I am a beast. They must have been tripping to have left me off a leash.
This is fire, 50 in Jeremih, number one, there's nothing higher.
Won't you go in?
Get it,
I see you, baby.
Work it, break it, break
won't
it,
just down. Put it
down.
Won't
you go in? Get it,
put it down,
work it, break it, break it, down.
Okay, she headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Someone like my wrist beats, everybody got the watching it. Girl, you got that secret treasure, I'm gon' put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not on it. Miss Vicky, heard you got that sticky. Let's go.
Party going, liquor flowing. This is fire. 50 in Jeremih. Break it, break it, down.
She headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Someone like my wrist beats, everybody got the watching it. Girl, you got that secret treasure. I'm gon' put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not on it. Miss Vicky. She headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Someone like my wrist beats, everybody got the watching it. Girl, you got that secret treasure. I'm gon' put a lock on it. To be not on in this fix. She headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Someone like my wrist beats, everybody got the watching it. Girl, you got that secret treasure, I'm gon' put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not on in this fix. She headed to the dance floor.
That's it. 10 minutes, start to finish. Woo! So, you know, real world applications of this. You know, I've been in jingle sessions where I had to record and mix an entire band for a 1 minute spot in 90 minutes, start to finish, in and out. Those things happen. You know, have a amazing singer walk into the studio ready to go, and you're not ready with a rough mix. That could be a really, really huge problem. So could my lack of lighting for the next minute, but we will persevere. So, I think you've heard enough of Down On Me for this evening. Love the full mix. Man, that's one of my favorites of my career. Okay, what's going to be next? There we go. Let's just plow into Q&A, and then I got some stuff to show you from the Beat Challenge real soon. COVID-free New Zealand Tony Richards asks, hey Ken, have you been asked to fix vocals in Melodyne note by note? Well, COVID-free New Zealand Tony Richards, congratulations, I am COVID-free too. I'm vaccinated and healthy and didn't get it. I have had to fix vocals far worse than Melodyning every note. You don't know the craziness that I have been through. Again, you got to back up to the weirdest resume in the entire music industry. One of my strengths is vocals. In any kind, vocal production, vocal mixing, vocal whatever, I'm vocals. And I have, so I'll tell you a story. I'm not going to tell you the artist, but we had an artist one time who cut a song and they sang the song. It was a super rhythmic song. And they sang the song with the drums muted, and we weren't at the session, and they had their engineer mute all the drums so that they could just sing to, like, some pads. And then they sent all of the vocals to me to put into the final production, and I listened to it, and against the drums, nothing sounded remotely close to where it belonged. And I took the vocal performance from the demo, which was a fire vocal performance, and by hand and with some alignment tools, I lined up the final vocal performance with the demo vocal performance. I mean, every single bit, and it felt exactly like it should. And it took like 14 hours to do that. And that was after the main vocal was comped. That was just realigning and fixing the timing of the lead vocal. You know, you got to do what you got to do. You know, I could have turned the work down. I wanted the work. Andy asks, "Hey Ken, has drugs or alcohol ever compromised the recording process?" Well, of course it has. But keep in mind, to every single person out there watching, listening, so much of the music that we all love was either written and or created and or performed by somebody who was on drugs. That's the music industry. It's not everybody by a long shot, but there's, you know, it's a fair amount of drug use in the music industry. And sometimes it can really spark creativity. And sometimes you just see somebody spiraling and nothing happens. And, you know, but you got to set your own ground rules for what your sessions want to be. I'm going to go to Jeremih Heatlie. So I'm going to run down the full beat challenge later, which it was awesome. But where is Jeremih Heatlie? Did I not put him on the one thing I didn't put on my launch? Okay. Jeremih, I'll find you. Here we go. Boom. I didn't put Jeremih into the top players because I wanted to pull his entry aside. And I had Jeremih send me an instrumental and a lead vocal separately. And this is, so his is the yellow lead vocal and the top instrumental. So I'm going to play you some of his entry with his vocals. And basically, when I heard his entry, I thought it was great. And but I felt like his vocal mic has some ringy resonant frequencies that are super, super harsh in the upper mids and the high frequencies. And I wanted to see if I could really smooth out that microphone and get the voice sounding really great with what he gave me. So I took the lead vocal, and he gave the KL Vokes is a dry lead vocal. Hey, Mazzy, lay down, baby. You be a good girl. So let me play you just a little bit of his entry, and then I'll show you how I fixed the vocal. Okay, so for those familiar with the beat challenge, the sample's in there. It's I love this music. It's great. I'm going to A-B between a line here. I'm going to start with Jeremih's, and then as soon as you see me switch, it's going to switch to my mock-up of it. And you can hear just how drastically I've changed the sound of his voice. Then I'm going to show you how. I long to tell you the things he says to you. I long to tell you the things he says to you. I long to tell you the things he says to you. Okay. Oh, I bet I had the mic on for that. You probably didn't hear the full effect. I long to tell you the things he says to you. I long to tell you the things. All right, so here's what I did. I tuned it first, just some gentle in key. The key is B flat major, so I put the detector in B flat major. I set the detector to alto tenor. Could have gone low male, but his range is pretty high, so alto tenor is about where he belongs. Retune speed, usually I go somewhere between 20 and 35. This felt like he was bendy a lot, and when a vocal is bendy, but I can still use auto-tune, I tend to use a slower retune speed. But sometimes it's just an experiment until you figure it out. Okay, so first thing was auto-tune. Second thing, I'm just getting rid of any room rumble that might be there. Didn't even listen, usually I do. And then I'm taking out three tiny little notches. Hi, Mazzy, lay down. Come on, lay down, baby. Good girl. Taking three tiny little notches in the mid-range where I'm hearing these resonant crap frequencies in the vocal. So I can't show you both at once, but let me...
And it breaks my heart that we might never be. And it breaks my heart. And it breaks my heart.
I don't know if you can really hear that. So the way I found those was, you know, I turned the vocal way up and then I just swept these frequencies really, really loud until I found one. I was like, oh, that's the one that's really a narrow band. What I'm looking for in these things is narrow, ringy frequencies that don't have any musical qualities to them. They don't sound like they're in key. They don't sound like they're particularly important in the lead vocal. And I'm taking out tiny little notches of those. And you got to be really, really careful because you will absolutely change the character of the sound of the vocal. So you just want to make sure that your end result doesn't change the vocalist from what they're supposed to sound like, because you certainly can. But inevitably, a lot of times what I will do, and I'll show you this here. So at the end of the chain, I took more tiny little cuts out. These look bigger than they are. They're actually pretty tiny little cuts. But then I'm boosting the entire upper frequency range at 10K, really strong with the pull tech. And I'm also boosting a bit of 5K. So in the same ranges that I've notched frequencies out, I'm then going back and adding kind of more global back because I want the energy in those frequencies. I just don't want that ringy shit that doesn't belong there. And that's exactly what Soothe does too. And I hit it with Soothe. Let me show you with and without.
And it breaks my heart that we might never be.
I don't know how, you know, here's maybe the best thing to show you. I'm gonna take everything off of the vocal chain and then put them back one by one.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
Auto-tune.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
Listen to the harshness in the high frequencies go away when I add the notches in the Soothe too. First off, listen to the harshness in the high frequencies.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. 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 But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
This is such a great tone shaping box. It's really a broad strokes box, but it's just such a super, super musical EQ. You know, whenever somebody talks about 3D EQs, I usually think that's a bunch of bullshit. But for whatever reason, this one sounds 3D to me. It just pulls things into your mix that just you weren't really hearing before. Okay.
Then I won't be selfish, I...
Okay, with the Sheps, I added a little bit of saturation, and then I boosted a little bit of mid-range at 6.7K. And then I added just a touch of de-essing. He really doesn't need any de-essing at all. The S's aren't cutting through at all, but I just took a little bit off just for the ch-ch-ch.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish.
See that saturation? It's not distortion. It's just a little bit of, you know, saturation just kind of thickens things up and just, for whatever reason, sometimes often makes things sound a little bit more real. So I think that's what is doing it for this one. Check it out.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
And then finally, distressor, just evening things out.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
And you see, I set my compression levels pretty much so that it's always working. That last little, the quietest bit is just barely blipping on the compressor. That's usually how I set my compression on vocals. Not always. You got to make sure you're not inverting things and that you're not adding so much compression that the loud parts get too quiet and the quiet parts get too loud. That can definitely happen, and that's just experience. Okay, one more time with the full chain off and on.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
Now effects. First is Pro R, FabFilter Pro R.
But I won't be selfish, I... But I won't...
Long but subtle, kind of tucked underneath just to let it ride, you know? And then the effects rack, check this out.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
It's almost like a slap delay, but this is something I tailored myself, and I just kind of played until I found something cool, and that was it. 5 and 6, I got a spring reverb on this, one of the Arturias. I love this Arturia spring reverb.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish.
And then finally we got the Arturia delay.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene.
That's a really nice one. And then this is the end result. And I'll play you the before and after. This is the before, starting with Jamie's, and then we'll go to mine.
But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't be selfish, I won't intervene. But I won't
Jamie.
Be
hear how a lot of that high frequency got tamed and a lot of the mid-range just really came out and is really present, and you can just hear the lyrics so much better.
Just be grateful of you, you're everything.
This is Jamie's original.
To see you smile, to be in your company.
Yeah, brings that mid-range really far forward. And my basic goals are, and I kind of do the same thing with mixing, is I'm trying to get rid of the stuff that doesn't belong in the vocal so that everything that does belong in the vocal can be loud and clear and musical and present. So that's kind of the goal. It takes a lot of experience, and you got to be really careful because something like Soothe 2 can ruin your vocal just as fast as it can help it. Same with notching things out. You can get crazy with it, and you can find things that you... really don't need to notch out, but you do anyway. That's kind of how you learn. You overdo it, and then you go like, oh shit, I ruined this. What did I do? And a lot of times, when you have this many plugins stacked up and it's just not sounding good, sometimes you just copy the entire channel, keep this chain so that you don't lose it, but mute it, and just start a fresh chain from scratch on your lead vocal again, and just start from scratch. don't think about what you just did. Just, you know, go through the whole process again and see what your result is. A lot of times, the second time through is just a better mental exercise. You know the vocal better, you know how it's going to react, and your choices are better. And sometimes you start with 7 plugins and you try again and you end with 3 or 4. It happens all the time. Okay. So that's, does anybody got any questions about that? Sorry, I haven't been really taking much questions. Josh S. asks, hey Ken, are panning and reverb the best tools to create space, like in this, in Down On Me or in Jamie's track? Those are certainly two of the best, panning and reverb. To create space, I do a lot of different things. You see on this, I'm creating a big hall for him to live in, but I'm also creating a shorter spring, which is a much more present verb. And then this slap thing is more like a spreader. So I'm building stages of where the ear hears it. And then you have this kind of floaty delay that floats in the background. So 4 different effects that build the, you know, the soundscape of where the vocal lives in that mix. So yeah, I think it's often a combination of, reverb or usually short delays or these kind of trailing delays underneath. Often I will build multiple layers if I'm trying to put a vocal in a big space, because you want the immediate presence, but then you want it to carry into reverb. So sometimes one reverb won't give you all of that, and you need something that'll give you that immediacy and also the carry. Sometimes you can get that from just a trailing ping pong delay. It just feels like it carries. Or you can put your ping pong delay into reverb, and then that ping pong delay feels like it just trails off into the distance. Lots of fun stuff to try. Okay, let me play you a little bit of Heart Games. So we produce an artist named Harler, and Harler just put out their new single on Friday called Heart Games. Please stream, support everything. Where is Harler? There's Harler. So check him out on Spotify. We've only got the audio thing up on YouTube right now, but I think we will have a full video up for it soon. But here's how you help independent artists thrive on streaming. You listen to their song, and then you like it, and then you add it to your playlist. Those 3 actions, listen, like, add to playlist, are huge for the algorithms. And listen all the way through. Don't stop. That's another big algorithmic boost. So for those who want to tell your own fan bases how, you know, the thing with getting playlisting on Spotify is a lot of it is algorithmic. And what you don't realize is how well your song performs on that playlist determines how long you stay on that playlist. So what does that mean? That means that if the person listening to that playlist, say it's the Rock This playlist or the New Music Friday playlist on Spotify, and you know they listen through to the song before yours and they hit your song, if they skip through your song in the first, you know, 20-30 seconds, that's algorithmically against you. If they listen to the entire thing start to finish, that helps. If they like it and add it to a playlist, that helps. And what it does is your song on that playlist is compared algorithmically to every other song on that playlist's performance. How many seconds is the average listen on the song before and after yours? If you get better results than the song before yours, chances are you're going to move up the playlist. That's how these things work. Okay, so enough playlisting, you know, stories. So we lost a great... we lost DMX. Rest in peace, DMX. I mixed one indie record that he was just a feature on, but nothing anybody would probably remember. Two of my very, very best studio stories involve DMX at Hit Factory in New York City in, I think it was 1999. And yeah, this is 1999, of course. So... back then, DMX and the Lox were all like best friends, and the Lox were on Bad Boy, and they had blown up. They had a bunch of big records out. DMX was obviously DMX. And so I was the tracking engineer on a Lox Foxy Brown Kid Capri session, but the only people there were Chic Louche and Styles P from the Lox. Jadakiss was not there that night. And later on, DMX stops in with a couple of his guys, and we had just recorded vocals for the Lox. And so we're at Hit Factory, the old Hit Factory, 54th Street in Manhattan, Studio C. And it's this big, long, it's kind of like this room. You walk in, and the console is like a 15-foot-long console right in front of you, a Neve VR. And I'm sitting at the console, and Styles P is sitting here, and Chic Louche is sitting here. And DMX is back on the back couch, not far from where the red couch is behind me, with a couple of his boys. And we're listening back to the playback of this song. Yeah, great song. So as we're listening to the playback of one of the Lox vocals, DMX stands up off the back couch and grabs the back of my chair. I had just a regular studio chair on wheels. And he pulls my chair back like this, and he spins me around. And I had like a button-down, just a regular button-down shirt on. And DMX proceeds, he's over me like this, and I'm just like taking all of this in very calmly. And again, I've got Chic Louche and Styles P of the Lox sitting right here and here watching this all happen. And DMX unbuttons my shirt down to about my belly button, and he's got his arm, or he's got his hand all over the front of my chest, and then he's got his hand all down the back of my shirt, and he's pulling my shirt around, and he's pulling me around. And the whole time he's talking, but I could barely make anything out. He was kind of incoherent. But the things that I did hear him say were FBI wire and informant. So he was legit searching me in the middle of a session that wasn't even his, to make sure that I wasn't a wired FBI informant. I shit you not, that happened. And that was not by far the craziest story of that night. So rest in peace, DMX. You definitely gave me two of my all-time best studio stories. Man, nobody did it like you, buddy. All right. What is next? Oh, you know, speaking of charmed lives, I told you guys at the beginning of the broadcast. By the way, if you're just tuning in, it's Ken Lewis and Mixing Night. Welcome to Mixing Night. Good to have you. Stick around. Tap a friend into the room. Come on, bring some people. Ear training is coming up. You do not want to miss that. Challenge your friends to ear training. Get them in here. Okay. What was I going to... I know I was going to show you. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay. So, I lead a charmed life. And I had... the former deputy director of the CIA at the, you know, here over the weekend. And I can't tell you what project we're working on, but it's some really, really fascinating shit. So I just wanted to share that, my strange, charmed life and one other of my prized possessions. This is the Love Yourself Answer album from BTS. It went... gold or platinum, I'm not sure. But this is handwritten from the band to me. This is one of my all-time prized possessions in the world. To Ken Lewis, the best engineer in the world. The best engineer in the world. It's an honor to be here with you. BTS. Yeah. When you talk about, like, you know... Who's calling me right now? Speaking of CIA, that's the CIA. So, you know, when you talk about impact and career and what things mean to you, that meant a lot. Okay, what? I'm gonna get back to a little bit of Q&A. Okay. Andrew asks, how important is the overall level of stems? So this is tracking engineering questions. How important is the overall level of stems And do you prefer to have stems for each mic used or consolidated and combined? So when I'm recording things that I produce, say I'm recording a drum kit, I will typically track everything to its own tracks. And I will always check phase as much as I can. Guitars and stuff, I usually treat a little bit different. Often I'll put two or three microphones on a guitar cabinet and I'll scope the entire cabinet and I'll find the best places in the entire cabinet because, man, it sounds radically different where you put the microphone really matters on a guitar amp. But then if I have two or three of the best, I'll combine those and I'll see how they go together best, and then I'll check phase and I'll see, you know, changing the phase by a small bit on two microphones on a guitar amp can radically change the sound of it. So if you're really tight on phase, then you can combine that stuff. If you're not, then leave it all separate and let the mix engineer correct it. Okay. Oh, I like this one. Okay. Eric Brown. Eric Brown asks, "Hey Ken, what's the longest time you've spent working on a song?" Eric. Oh, Eric. A long, long time. Okay, so this is kind of a loaded question because the true answer is, I develop artists a lot, and when you do artist development, sometimes a song evolves over the course of sometimes years, and often you're picking it up and you're working on it and you're tweaking it, you know, and you put it back away, and you're, so there's times where songs have come out years later that we worked on, and then all, like a good judge would be like, and when we were making the Des Rocks album, it was me, Brent, and Des Rocks just doing the first two EPs. And I'd say we probably spent a solid 2 weeks per song on recording and trying production ideas and things like that. So a lot. And this is your competition. Indie artists, wake up. If you're not getting traction, you're like, man, I keep doing this. Are you spending 2 weeks perfecting your song? Because you have three record makers who are seasoned at doing this, spending that much time on one song for a release. And that's what you're trying to compete with. So some of this is just a real gut check of like, oh shit, I gotta figure out on a pro level how to compete again. I'm not doing this. Okay, so... Hopefully I answered that okay. Pablo Tassi asks, "Hey Ken, when finishing a mix, which values of integrated loudness and or true peak do you target before mastering?" I'm not really sure exactly what you're asking because I don't think like that at all. But you might be asking like LUFS and RMS targets and things like that. I don't think about LUFS. I couldn't give the first fuck about LUFS. It never crosses my mind, literally. RMS is what crosses my mind. And my RMS targets, I'll show you guys during the beat challenge. I'm going to show you guys a lot of mastering. So my RMS targets on the Slate FGX are between -7 and -9. And I usually just keep the Slate FGX and bypass and use it as a meter. I'll show you guys that later. Okay. What time is it? 8:50. Oh, ear training's coming up. Oh. All right. Rapid fire frequencies tonight on Down On Me, actually. So you'll have a song that you guys should be really familiar with. Hey, beggar, come on, lay down. We got Mazzy on the Mazzy cam tonight, holding it down, keeping us safe around here. Everybody should have a hellhound on staff. Okay. Let's see. Nicholas asks, "Hey Ken, do you discuss business before creating with someone, like splits, payments, royalties, etc., or are contracts stifling to the creative process?" I find that creative people should never talk business. That's what managers are for. And if you don't have managers, then it's usually understood that if everybody's in a room creating together, it's even splits. That's not always the case, but that's usually the case. So if you're one of those people in that room getting an even split, you make sure you are contributing and earning that even split. And also know that, you know, sometimes, you know, if you do a lot of sessions and writing sessions and production sessions and stuff like that, as a top liner, because I'm a top liner too, sometimes your pen is on fire and you are just cranking out lyrics. And sometimes your pen is stuck and glued and nothing's coming out. And those things just tend to even themselves out. And so if you go around your sessions going like, well, I wrote 80% of the lines and you wrote 20, so I should, you're going to have a hard time collaborating with people. And you just got to realize that every day is a different experience, and sometimes you're going to be the leader and sometimes you're going to be the follower, and it all adds up in the end. Okay. Steven asks, hey Ken, I've always been digital all the way, but I always hear from the old school guys, like me, that analog gear sounds different over time. Like, it, you know, once the tubes warm up. Have I noticed that? And if so, is that something plugins are missing? A button to emulate the sound over time? No, I mean, I think what you've heard is like, take a U47, like a classic Neumann U47. You're not supposed to leave those things on more than, I don't know, 4 or 8 hours, something like that, because, you know, you can wear out the tubes or overheat them, or, you know, they're just not stable. But I have a Sony C800G, the one with the big black fin off the back of it. Well, that fin off the back holds the tube in it, and it's also one giant heat sink. So that fin draws heat away from the microphone capsule and keeps the microphone capsule very stable. And the problem with the older microphones is they would heat up, and the heat would go up into the capsule and it would change the temperature of the capsule and it would perform differently. But differently better? You know, maybe, maybe not. Maybe differently worse. So don't worry about differently. Analog and digital is all tactile experience. That's all it is. You can get the same result on either one. It's use what you feel most creative using. I feel most creative sitting in front of a console, because this is how I came up in the industry. But if you mix with a mouse and you're super comfortable that way, then more power to you. I can do it. I just don't really enjoy doing it, you know? And I feel like the mental component of mixing is a really powerful one. Like, you've got to be hopefully in the right frame of mind when you're trying to finish a song. And I think it can just help you creatively if you're in the zone. Hey, you, lay down. You be a good girl. Stop begging. I know this is the best treats night of the year, but give me some slack. All right, what time is it? 8:55. Ooh, we're going to go ear training in a minute. But, you know, I'm going to do Marcus Manderson Mixing Night Man of Mystery, and then we're going to go to ear training. So Marcus is going to break down the Cymatics Diablo beat plugin. Check it out.
What's good? This is Marcus Manderson, Mixing Night Man of Mystery, back with another Mixing Night Man of Mystery moment. As you can tell from the intro, today is all about Diablo Light. Diablo Light is a drum enhancer plugin by Cymatics. So here we are on the Cymatics website, cymatics.fm. I will share the link to this in the Discord group, but it is a free plugin that you can use on your drums, on your 808s, really on anything you want to add it to. It has five knobs here that you can adjust and tweak to taste. So what we'll do is we'll finish an idea that we started previously using UVI Workstation, and we'll add some drums from a free Cymatics kit here from the free Cobra Hip Hop Sample Pack. If you go to cymatics.fm, go to free download, you can download all these free sample packs, free sounds, free serum presets and guides and cheat sheets, etc. So we'll jump over to Logic here. Here is an example of the Diablo Light plugin. You have punch, clip, input, output, and wet dry signal you can adjust using this mix knob here. So what I'll do is I will play a sample of those hi-hats that I imported over. So here is the hi-hat loop I brought from the Cymatics Cobra Hip Hop Sample Kit. So that is without Diablo Light. Here it is with it. So you see when the audio is playing, you get the level signals here and like sort of that reddish orange color, and then the graphic here also lights up with that reddish orange color. It's very great graphical user interface here. And here is the drum loop I imported from the Cobra hip hop sample pack from Cymatics. And we will engage Diablo Light. Here we go. So there you go. You hear it punching through. So here is everything all together with those UVI sounds that we started in a previous Mixing Night Meta Mystery Moment segment. So there you have it. Shout out to Cymatics. Again, check out the Diablo Light Drum Enhancer plugin. If you're interested in getting more features from Diablo, they do have a paid version. If it's still under $4,000 when you pay $100, you also get the full version of Diablo and this Vortex 808 Enhancer. The full version of Diablo comes with some more knobs such as boost and body and heat and things like that. And then you also get this Vortex 808 Enhancer, 808 Designer. But Diablo Light is just as capable. I use it on my drums and 808s all the time. And also check out the free sounds you get from them here. Again, some great sound packs that you can use for free, royalty free, in your productions also. Shout out to Cymatics. Definitely check out Diablo. Thank you for checking this out. This has been Marcus Manderson, Mixing Night Man of Mystery, with another Mixing Night Man of Mystery moment. Be safe and be well, everyone. All right, peace.
Love that guy. Another great segment. Thank you very much, Marcus Manderson, Mixing Night Man of Mystery, a.k.a. DeFinga's on the beat. He's got a beat in the beat challenge as well, which I'm going to go to in a bit, but I'm going to get to ear training in a moment. Let me answer a couple questions before. From the chat roll, Anoop Bahave? Bahave? Sorry. Have you mixed any Bollywood songs, Ken? Thank you. Anoop, I have mixed Bollywood songs. For the life of me, I cannot remember what they are. ARR Rockman reached out to me one time to collaborate with him and T-Pain. We were all three going to do a song together, and this was right after like Slumdog Millionaire when he was huge. And I don't know why he reached out to me, but I wish he would again. I would love to work with him, but it just never came together. So I don't know if this T-Pain, I don't know what happened, but it never materialized, but I would love to work with him. I was talking about our artist, Harler, but then I never played them for you. So here is like 30 seconds of Heart Games. Please support them and, stream, save, all those things.
We'll call you in a haze with the tire clock, and the feelings don't fade. So can we talk? Oh, honey, you can play with my heart. Cause I think I'm gonna like all these scars when you're gone. And you can get closer, I swear. I won't run. But these heart games leave me dead when you're done. I like it on the edge.
Awesome. So, Harler, Heart Games, please support. And do you guys love this artwork or what? So, the people that do the artwork for, I think, Coldplay and Chainsmokers do our artwork. And, man, they are just fantastic. So, okay, that's new, Harler. Thank you for supporting. Let's go to ear training. Oh, yes. Ear training. And, okay. So tonight is Rapid Fire Frequencies. Get ready, get focused, and let's go. I will be playing Down On Me by Jeremih and 50 Cent. If you don't have the worksheet yet, you can go to the description of the video you're watching right now. The worksheet is in the description. Download it and follow along. Let's see. So I'm going to start by playing you like 30 seconds of the untreated Down On Me mix, just the store, you know, the finished thing. So you can get it in your brain, what it sounds like, where everything belongs, how it all sits. And then once I start with rapid fire, I basically every four bars or so in the song, it changes, and it's going to give you a different, very highly boosted frequency. And you have to guess what frequency is being boosted. So here are the two twists. We have 18 examples. Of those 18 examples, no frequency repeats at all. So it's a, and it's always on the evens, you know, 300, 500, 600, 800, 900, 1K, 3K, 7K, 9K, 12K, those kind of, you know. And so none of those ever repeat, and one of the 18 has no EQ boost at all. It's just flat. So I'm going to play through the entire thing twice through, and then I'm going to reveal the answers with my very spoiled dog. So here is the untreated Down On Me to get your ears dialed in. Are you ready for rapid fire frequencies? Once it starts, it does not stop. Here is number one. Let's go.
She want it, I can tell she want it. Want me to push up on it, for she know where I'm all on it. We get the party going, liquor flowing, this is fire. 50 and Jeremih, number one, there's nothing higher.
Won't you
get it, get it.
I see you, baby.
Work it, work it,
work it. Won't you just down, put it down.
Okay, she headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Song like my wrist piece, everybody got to watching it. Girl, you got that secret treasure, I'm gonna put a lock on it. Don't care what they say, I would be stupid to be not owning this Vicky. Heard you got that sticky. Let's go and take 9 shots, we'll just call it 50. And I'm gonna lick it, lick it, lick it till they icky. Had that river running, keep you gunning till you empty.
Bang, 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 bang.
Oh, you look so sweet. What you working, Alice? Look at your physique. Yo, you are a beauty. Well, I am a beast. They must have been tripping to have left me off a leash.
I like the way you grind with that booty on me. Sorry you were down while you looking lonely. Go buy another round and it's all on me. As long as I'm around, put it down on me. Just put it down on me. Put it down on me. Down, down on me. Put it down on me. Don't throw it off the mound. Show me how it's gonna be. Girl, all I really want is you down on me. Put it down on me.
I'm thumping, party jumping. Shorty, she's a perfect teen. She rock her hips, then roll her hips, then drop it down like it's nothing. She just like an hourglass. You see how fast an hour pass. Time flies when I'm on that ass, but I won't put our shit on blast.
Work it like a
9.
Watch it go, do a thing out on the floor. She bouncing fast, she shaking slow. So sexual, incredible. She beautiful, she edible. I got her, I won't let her go. I ain't seen nothing better, yo.
Look how she twerk it, the way she work it. Make me wanna hit it, heaven when I'm in it, in it. If I do not fit, I'm gonna make it. Girl, you can take it. Don't stop,
I like
get it,
the way
get it.
You ride with that booty.
put it down on me.
Okay, second time through, what I'm going to do is play it in like the last, each of it is about four bar segments. About the last bar of it, I'm going to tell you what the correct answer is. And then after we listen through the second time, then I'll post the full answer sheet up on screen for you to double check. But be paying attention to me. I'm going to shout out the frequency of the correct answer. A little over halfway through the listen this time, so you get one more listen each to lock them in. Again, here's a reset of your ears on the full mix. Okay, rapid fire frequencies. You get, I'm going to listen a little over halfway through, and then I'm going to tell you what the answer is.
She want it, I can tell she want it. Want me to push up on it, for she know where I'm all on it. We get the party going, liquor flowing, this is fire.
800 hertz, 800. Get it, 5K.
Okay, she headed to the dance floor and she slowly started popping it. Song like my wrist beats, everybody got to watching it. Girl, you got that secret treasure.
100 hertz.
I would be stupid to be my own in this picky. Heard you got that sticky. Let's go and take 9 shots, we'll just call it 50. And I'm gonna lick it till a hickey. Had a
rip. No change at all, no change.
Oh, you look so sweet. What you working, palace? Look at your physique. Girl, you are a beauty. Well, I am a beast.
3K. 3K.
Left me off a leash.
I like the way you grind with that booty on me. Sorry you were down while you looking lonely. Go buy another round and it's all on me.
500 hertz.
500.
Six K.
I'm thumping, party jumping, show that she's a perfect ten. She rock her hips and roll her hips and drop it down like it's nothing. She just like a
700 hertz. 700 hertz.
When I'm on that ass, but I won't put our shit on blur.
Work it like a pro, sit and watch it go. Do a thing out on the floor. She bouncing fast and shake it slow, so sexual, incredible.
10K.
I won't let her go. I ain't seen nothing better, yo.
Look how she twerk it, the way she worked it. Make me wanna hit it, heaven when I'm in it. If I do not,
1K. 1K.
Girl, you can take it. Don't stop, get it.
Sixty hertz.
Just put it down on me, put it down on me. Down on me, put it down on me. Don't know it off the mound on me, how it's gonna be.
900.
Put it down on me.
Say you independent, get it from your mama. Tell me if you with it. Do you really wanna? Baby, when you see me, you know I'll be on it. Can you keep it up?
600. That was 600. It's 4K. Number 14 is 4K. 16K. Number 15 is 16K.
Three hundred.
200 hertz. That was 7K. 7K. How did everybody do? Check the chat roll. Post up your results. So I'm going to put the answer sheet up on screen. And then I'm just going to skip around and play through just pieces of each of the selections. No, that's not it. Answers. Boom. Okay. Here's the answers. And let's see how you did. What? Hey, that's not... there we go. Okay. I'll play through just the starts of them one more time. 800 hertz.
She want it, I can tell she want it. Want me to push up on it, for she know where I'm all on.
5K.
Get it, I see you, baby.
Work it, break it,
won't you just put it down.
100 hertz.
Headed to the dance floor and she slowly start to popping it. Song like my recipes, everybody got to watch it.
No change.
Heard you got that sticky. Let's go and take 9 shots, we'll just call it 50. And I gonna lick it, lick it, lick it till I hit.
3K.
Oh, oh, you look so sweet. What you working about, Alice? Look at your physique. Girl, you are a beauty. Well, I am a beast.
500.
Cry with that booty on me. Sorry you were down while you looking lonely. Go buy another round and it's...
6K.
Me put it down on me. Down, down on me. Put it down on me. Don't throw it off the mound. Show me how it's going.
700.
Thumping, party jumping, shorty, she's a perfect teen. She rock her hips, then roll her hips, then drop it down like it's nothing. She just like an hourglass. You see how fast an hour passes. Time flies when I'm
working like a
10K. Number 9 is 10K. 1K.
She worked it. Make me wanna hit it, heaven when I'm in it, if I
60.
Nine hundred.
600. 4K.
Get it from your mama. Tell me if you with it. Do you really wanna?
16K. $300. 7K. All right, post up. How did everybody do? I hope you guys all slayed that one. All right. So, yeah, like I said, I've been hearing about studios and recording programs, dorm rooms and whatnot, having these, like, ear training challenges where people are getting together and, you know, and so if you're one of those people doing that right now, I think that is the coolest thing in the entire world. And if you're not doing that yet, then I highly encourage you to find some audio friends and go back to previous episodes. All of these broadcasts restream, and you can go straight to the ear training segment, download that ear training worksheet, and you and your friends can all challenge each other to whatever that one is. I mean, we've done like 30 episodes now, so there's a lot you guys can really dig into and improve your hearing and challenge yourselves. And yeah, so good luck. What's next? The beat challenge. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, the beat challenge, I'm going to play you what I... So, here's the starter that I fed you guys up a couple weeks ago. And, here, I'll just play for you. Okay, so that's royalty-free. I served it up for you, told you guys, do whatever you want with it. Flip it, pitch it, cook up, whatever. You guys went crazy. There are just so many cool different examples. So basically what I'm going to do, this is going to run for about 6 minutes. So I put together, I think, 14 of the top submissions, and I just put together like 4 to 8 bars of each. And they run back to back to back to back. So you hear one go right into the other. And my goal with putting these together this way was to show you guys that from one simple single starter that I just played you, every single thing that you're about to hear was inspired by and created from that starter. And this is really the most valuable lesson about production and creativity, is that there is no right answer. There is no wrong answer. There is no right or wrong direction. There is only where you take things and how much you personally connect with it, and then how much others connect with what you're doing. So with that in mind, I'm going to hit play. Actually, and the top 14, here they are in order that I'm going to play them. This is random order. This is not like best to worst. This was, I put this together how I felt like everything flowed best one into the other. So there's like a trap section and a pop section and a rock section, and you'll see. So yeah, I'll just leave this up and take in the beat challenge. This was a really great one. So here we go. And these are just excerpts. Is this totally nuts, all the different directions? The fingers on the beat, Marcus Manderson. Kev J.
What's he about to do? Watch the people watch. when I make my move, make a move. Where I'm coming from, people don't make
it's like
it
a Jurassic 5 throwback.
From the depths of doubt, we turn courage from fear, alchemizing a new sound, making vibes for the people to dance and get down. Come together as one, the human race can't drown. When we're all here for cheers, hugs and pounds, united we are strong, so they can't divide us now. The revolution's in the mind, and that's my theory to allow.
Three sections.
Do it again,
yeah. DMX. This is Joel Wright. I love the way this builds. This whole thing just builds epically. Really great. Joshua Schultz. Absolutely love the controlled chaos here at the end. Woo! Great work, great work. So that the Brian Pepin one, I'm gonna pull up the full session if I have time in a moment and show you all the crazy controlled chaos. I had him send me stems. Really brilliant stuff. The other person that I wanted to, I'm probably going to pull this up next show if I can, was Nicholas Sosin did the, where is it? I'll find it. Give me a moment. Here we go. I'm just going to, yeah, here we go. I'm going to play you a bit of this. Shameless pandering. Bananas. That's so cool, Nicholas. So I loved what you did, but I feel like those vocals can be tightened up in the mix, and I can show you how to make that chant really sound like a major label mix. So I don't know if I'm gonna have, I don't think I have time tonight. I couldn't put all these stems together, but I'm hoping to show you guys the full mix breakdown of that, and just some vocal tricks that I can show you guys with trap that can really lock in these types of vocals. You know? So, yeah. Okay. And the winner is, drum roll, please. So, I just, before I announce the winner, I gotta say, this person went so hard on this. I was just so incredibly impressed. He did an entire song. It was like a 5-minute epic trilogy of different sections, and was he... You just wait here. Boom. Bobby Thymgen. I hope I get that right. Bobby Thymgen. He titled his entry song The Great Golden Fool. So Bobby Thymgen, with The Great Golden Fool, you win a UVI Falcon workstation. And trust me, dude, you're going to love that shit. I use that stuff all the time. I love it. The UVI is very much like the NI Complete or Arturia or, you know, one of those collections like that. It's like, you know, you add libraries and things like that, kind of like Kontakt. Okay, so that was the beat challenge. Oh, shit. You know, if I didn't have my wife in the control room keeping me on pace here. I'm not even high. I mean, I am totally sober and wow. Okay. Here's the, I'm going to see how long his entry was. This is just incredible. I'm just going to play you a few excerpts. Here's my favorite part of how he chopped up the sample. Okay. And then the three favorite sections of mine. I love how he took the sample and moved it to guitar and then changed the phrasing. Different drum patterns, different underneath. This is my favorite mood right here. I wish I could play the whole thing start to finish. It's a great listen. So, and on that note, over at the Mixing Night Discord channel, if you haven't checked that place out yet, it's such a great creative community. There for, you know, exchanging ideas and getting people to listen to your stuff and giving people listens and things like that. So check out the Mixing Night Discord. On Mixing Night Discord, we have put an entire playlist of all of the entries. Because you see, like, these are all, you know, here's the full entries. I mean, some of these go for a long time. So we put all of the full entries on a full playlist, a SoundCloud playlist on the Mixing Night Discord channel. Check that out. And, you know, if you're coming up in the world as a producer, it's a great tool to figure out what everybody else is doing, where your skills line up with others, and just to kind of understand how many different creative paths are possible, and that any given day you might wake up and make the most amazing, incredible thing of your life. So I hope that's tomorrow. What's next on the show? All right, so that was the beat challenge, and I didn't forget to play the winner. Oh, but I did. I swear to God. I'm going to show you some of the mastering that I did on the... Okay. So if you see several of these channels, I have the BX limiter engaged on. And basically what I did was, through the whole listening experience, I just wanted to even out, just like a mastering engineer would basically do, even out the levels so that one song, one entry sounds like it flows evenly at the same general volume to the next one, to the next, to the next. So I'm going to go through and break down. I'm just going to do a little A-Bing and show you a couple techniques that I'm working on with this. But here's the first one that I showed you. This is just a little squeeze. It's nothing, you know. No more sorries, no more pain. I don't really know how. I can't be pushing my... I think I checked all of the RMS on... I put a Slate FGX on the mix bus in bypass just so I can have the metering, because that's the only RMS meter that I truly know is the Slate FGX. And it works in bypass on HGX systems. So all of these fall between minus 7 and minus 9 RMS. Let me go to Education Beats. Show you what I did to his. So I'm just giving it a little bit of a squeeze. You see, I'm the ceiling, I have it 0.08. You want to keep a little bit of that streaming ceiling for streaming. 0.08 is fine. 0.1 is safer. And nobody's really going to ever hear the difference. We're talking about tenths of a dB. It's really hard to hear. Or hundredths of a dB, actually. And then this XL is kind of like a... I don't know if it's like a parallel saturator. I'm not really sure what the fuck XL does. But it's definitely saturates some shit. And so I'm just using a little bit of saturation and a little bit of gain on this. Nothing major. All right, this next one is the real, like, dig in. So, this one.
What's he about to say?
About to say.
What's he about to do?
About to do.
Watch the people watch.
Watch, watch.
When I make my move, make a move.
Where I'm coming from, people don't make it out. We turn art to beauty from the depths of doubt. We turn courage from fear, alchemizing a new sound. Making vibes for the people to dance and get down. Come together as one, the human.
Okay. Huge, huge difference. And not a perfect job, but a pretty good job for how quickly I did it. So this is one of the real hidden powers of this box. The limiter mix knob right here. Well, there's two things. The foundation. The foundation is basically a tilt. So if you go left, you're tilting towards bright, and you're basically adding top and shaving off bottom. That's how the tilt works. If you tilt right, you're adding bottom and shaving off top. So I'm adjusting it very slightly here. I'm adding a little bit of, a significant amount of parallel saturation, I guess. I slowed down my release so that it won't pump as much, because I'm really pushing the shit out of the controller. But here's where the magic comes in on this box, is the limiter mix percent, this thing that says 53. Let me show. So this is like, it's a parallel, so it's just adding that much mixer into your mix. So let me show you. I'll take it from 0 to 100 and then back to 53, so you can hear how drastic it is all the way. And basically, so I'm blending dry signal with this. The 100% affected signal is being blended with the 0% affected signal. That's what's happening. So, all right.
What's he about to say?
About to say.
What's he about to do?
About to do.
Watch the people watch.
Watch, watch.
When I make my move, make a move.
Where I'm coming from, people don't make it out. We turn art to beauty from the depths of doubt. We turn courage from fear, alchemizing a new sound. Making vibes for the people to dance and get down. Come together as one, the human race can't drown. When we're all here for cheers, hugs and pounds. United we are strong, so they can't divide us now. The revolution's in the mind, and that's my theory to allow.
What's he about to say?
About to say.
What's he about to do?
About to do.
Watch the people watch.
Watch, watch.
When I make my move, make a move.
Where I'm coming from, people don't make it out. We turn art to beauty from the depths of doubt. We turn courage from...
That's one of my favorite ones with this. That limiter, wet dry, the thing I have on 53, what a huge difference. I can definitely see... to me, that's just a huge bonus, and offers you a lot of different sonic choices. And then the next one, MBI. I don't know what I did with this. Let's. You can see the foundation is at -3, so I'm adding some high end and rolling off a little bit of low. Full 100% mix on the limiter, and I'm pushing it a little bit. This isn't very pushed at all. You know, know, the goal on mastering is to not get it so loud that your drums have no impact anymore and it's just volume coming at you. You want those drums to hit, but, you know, everything else to still be loud. That's the trick. So let's see if I'm doing anything else worth showing on any of these. I'll just check them real quick. I can't get to the bottom buttons. I have to make my screen really big so that it broadcasts well, and I can't even see the bottom of this controller to use it right now. So anyway, I'll go to the next one. Anyway, I think you guys get the idea. So the limiter is obviously, it's really handy, and you can get a lot of different tones and moods out of it, aside from it just being like your final volume leveling box. Which I've been using it for. I think I'm about 6 or 7 mixes in on it by now, and it's definitely in the arsenal for good. It's staying. So check it out. It's definitely a good one. Let's see. What is next? I already did Marcus Manderson. We did. Let me check out some more questions. Nora asks, hey Ken, what things do you have to consider when you start companies like your production team Catalyst or the show Mixing Night? The biggest things to consider really are time management. Do I really have the time to do this well? If not, maybe I shouldn't. Sometimes you just want to, you know, but, you know, typically speaking, nothing that you want to do is going to be truly successful unless you can throw most or all of yourself into it. And you find the things that you're passionate about and you go all in on the things that you're passionate about that you also think might, you know, give you a career. You know, you just got to balance it a little bit. John Magnificent asks, hey Ken, what is the most valuable skill that you possess in mixing? The one skill that you knew you were going to be successful now that you had it. Ooh, John, I like that question. So, I think that skill is being a finisher. And, if you struggle to find the finish line with like your mix or your production or your songwriting, then you're not yet a finisher. And that is a real skill that you learn and develop over time of knowing where the finish line is, knowing how to get to the finish line, and knowing when you're there and to stop. So that has been a huge learning process, and I think that's the biggest superpower, being a finisher. Vincent asks, hey Ken, how do you avoid phasing issues when EQing? Vincent, I don't think about them. I'm sure I incur some phase when EQing, but I just use my ears, and if I EQ something and I hear other problems, then I'll ask myself why, and maybe I undo something, or maybe I try a different, you know, I don't think about it. I think about music when I'm EQing. Ian, MBI Ian asks, can you tell us about your time working with DMX? I told you guys the FBI story earlier. And also, the bass in the background, is that a vintage Fender Tele? He's talking about this one. This is it's a reissue, 1951 reissue Fender Precision bass. It sounds gorgeous, and I use this on most of the records that I play on. I also have, as the knob falls off, I also have a Variax bass that I like a whole lot, but I just like playing this one better. But it's a reissue, and actually this was gifted to me by Don Miggs after I produced the Miggs Wide Awake album. So thank you, Don Miggs. It has made its way onto a whole lot of records since I acquired it. Odell asks, hey Ken, do I need music theory or is it an asset to have it? No, you do not need music theory. Yes, it is an asset to have it. Here's why. Knowing music theory is like knowing the language of music. It helps you communicate with other people who speak that language. It doesn't necessarily have to dictate any of your musical actions or decisions, but it can help you understand the situations that you're in. And if you're ever, say you're in a session and the artist is like, let's take it from the bar 17, and you're like, I don't know what bar 17 is, this song is in 7/8. What did they just say to me? So knowing even just the basics of the nomenclature and things like that, and then just knowing some of the basics of music theory from a communication with others during sessions standpoint, I think can help you a lot. From the creative standpoint, everybody uses theory differently. And I have seen theory just ruin people's songwriting because all of a sudden you get this rule book and you can't escape from the rule book. And great songwriters rarely look at a rule book. So there's some food for thought for both ways. Jason asks, hey Ken, how do you add depth to your mixes? Obviously tools like reverb, EQ, etc. But how do you use them to create a sense of depth? I think I just answered that a little bit earlier on. But a lot of times I'll stack different lengths of reverb. So I'll have a real short present reverb and then a much longer one. And I'll blend those two so I can get kind of impact and then distance. Not always, but often I will build two or three stages of reverb and or effect that way. Sometimes it's a, like I showed earlier, a pitch spreader. I think that one was Soundtoys, the effects rack. And it's just kind of like a pitch slap delay is all it was. And that kind of spreads it out so that you have already a sense just with that of you're in a slightly different space. And then the reverb on top of that kind of fills you in a little bit. And then the carry reverb, and then you're really cooking with gas. So you don't always have to stack effects. And a lot of times, man, the best thing you can do to a vocal is listen to it bone dry right up in front of the mix and see what it feels like first. So many times I'll get a rough mix in, and the rough mix is just dripping with reverb, or there's just a really noticeable reverb on the lead vocal. And I listened to it. It just happened the other day. And I mixed especially verse one, just bone dry, really intimate, in your face, and then let the reverb start carrying, at the pre-chorus and the chorus, and then you build an emotion into the song. And the client loved it. So maybe I'll play that for you next week. Now let's see, it's 9:45. Oh, I can pull up Brian's, I think I can. Let's find out. Ba-ba-ba. Here it is. So the Brian Pepin submission, the real crazy, chaotic, frantic one, I wanted to pull it up real quick and show it to you. Because I didn't spend a whole lot of time balancing it perfectly well, so it's not going to sound as good as his submission does. Hey, you. I have a begging dog here. Are you a good girl? Yes, you are. Mazakeen Lewis says hello. So this is Ken Lewis and Mixing Night, if you've just joined us. Glad to have you. So, okay. So Brian's submission had this real, like, controlled chaos about it, and I really wanted to know how he achieved that. And I gotta tell you, so a lot of it was sidechain pumping. So he created a real, like, bouncy beat just with everything sidechain pumping, and then he crafted four layers of these vocals. Listen to these vocals. And you feel how everything bounces on that side chain. So you're always feeling this pulse. Boom, 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 the whole time. And it even through all of that chaos, it kind of manages it all for you. So here's more. These are chop-ups of the sample loop of the starter. I just wanted to show you some of those cool things. I really like the way he put this together. So I just found it fascinating how many different iterations of the sample he took and then chopped up and looped and glitched and all of this other stuff. And it just created this really almost euphoric chaos. So go to the SoundCloud listen list on Discord and listen to his full submission. It's just pop fantastic. I'm going to... Well, I guess I can do a little bit more Q&A. If there's any more questions on the chat roll, fire away. Kevin Dietz on the chat roll asks, hey, Ken, do you find yourself recording live instruments for pop or hip-hop in recent times, like acoustic drums or guitars, bass, etc.? Acoustic drums less and less, although still on the stuff that we produce, we actually do acoustic drums a fair amount. So really as a producer, actually, yeah, Dominic, co-founder of Mixing Night, played drums on a bunch of the Skrizzly Adams stuff. All the live drums on Too Close to Fire and 28 are Dominic. That's not uncommon for me to throw live drums on. Same with, the Des Rock stuff has live drums. Skrizzly Adams has live drums, guitars, bass. It's a rock shop around here. I mean, you know, I do trap and all the weirdest resume in the music industry. I do it all. I'm just as comfortable doing trap as I am producing a Des Rocks record. It's a strange and charmed career. So, let's see. All right. I think I got to all of the questions. So I'm going to end the night sprint mixing one of my favorite sprint mixes, Sacred Circles, Lazarus. Boom, there it is. What a great song. So I haven't sprinted this in a while, and if you haven't heard this, man, this is rock fantastic. Again, the group is Lazarus. The song is called Sacred Circles. You can buy the Sacred Circles Sprint if you're feeling challenging. So where are they? Here we go. So at my school, audioschoolonline.com, I have a bunch of these sprint mixes, and they're each one of these comes with all six levels, 1 through 6. Level one is I've never mixed anything in my life, and level six is I'm a badass and I'm challenging Ken Lewis. And then you get the marathon session, which is the entire full tracked out. I think like Temptation has like 70 stems. So you can really then practice your full mixing skills at length with the marathon session after you tackle the sprints. So if you want to improve your mixing skills, I guarantee you that is the absolute fastest way to do it. No lying. So check those out. I covered all of those things. And all right, I guess I gotta stop delaying and put the 10 minutes on the clock. So if you're just tuning in, what are sprint mixes? It's 10 minutes on the clock, approximately 30 mixed stems, all randomized volume. So I have no idea what the volumes are supposed to be. And I set 10 minutes on my timer, a 3-minute song, and I have that much time to make the entire thing sound like the best rough mix that I can, which basically gives me about 20 seconds per stem to make all final decisions for where that goes on every single stem. So you got to work very fast. It trains your instincts, it trains your focus, and it trains your ability to very quickly listen to two sounds, balance them against each other, and move on to the next. And that is a skill that you use all day, every day. Every time you listen to two sounds in the studio, for any reason, you're mentally or physically balancing those things against each other. And sprint mixing teaches you how to do that without even thinking about it. It just becomes natural. It's like, oh, boom. All right, boom, next. So without further ado, I'm going to mask up. So I'm vaccinated, but please stay safe out there. COVID is still raging, and if you're not vaccinated yet, get vaccinated when you can, and don't get COVID before you get vaccinated. So it's been Ken Lewis and Mixing Night. I'm going to put the disco lights on and put 10 minutes on the clock, and thank you all for joining me for another great night. I appreciate you. And where is 10 minutes? Sacred Circles, Ken Lewis Mixing Night. Have a great night, everybody.
Impossible. There's no such thing as coincidence. Begin to track your feet along the path. Philosophies that counteract, connect to it, rethink, and anything that flees can be real. The cold, the tiniest of particles, the fact you're so remarkable. Impossible. such thing as coincidence.
Make it a part of me. You cause and your core. Let my team, your sacred circle. Show me your sacred circle. Make it shine. Your sacred circle.
Whew. That's it. 10 minutes start to finish. Now, if you were paying attention, you saw me turn that hi-hat up by about 10 dB right at the end. And that's the thing. I couldn't solve, like, what the hell is wrong with my mix? It just isn't feeling completely locked in. And I'm just searching, and I just listen, and I just ask myself, what is the mix missing? And I was missing that drive from the hi-hats. And, you know, I was getting plenty of drive in the choruses from the cymbals and whatnot, but the verses, hi-hats just weren't there. So, you know, all that full 10 minutes, I needed every last moment of it. And so I'm going to ride the night out printing this pass down. This is Ken Lewis with Mixing Night. This is Sacred Circles by Lazarus Sprint Mix. And I will see you again in 2 weeks. You all have a great night, and thanks for joining me tonight.
It must be.